Hello, CA Foundation students. How are you all? Hope so you all are good and doing well at your home. I am doing studies very seriously, as you all know, because exams are very near and only 1 month is remaining, and you have to plan all of your revisions and you have to do your study very properly as you are having your exams in December, and December is very near, guys. Okay, and hope so you have completed with maximum of your syllabus of business economics and BCK, and you are doing the MCQ practice, because for the objective papers, MCQ practice is must have. Okay, so once again, Prachi Paliwal this side will teach you business economics and BCK for CA Foundation December 2021. So all of you are ready? Okay, so before starting with today's lecture, I want to tell you that today in this lecture, we are going to revise quickly all of the concepts related to business cycle. So in this lecture, in this lecture itself, we are going to revise all of the concepts related to business cycle. We can say it is a one-shot revision of business cycle chapter. In just one lecture, you are able to revise all of the things related to business cycle. Is it clear? So before starting up with the revision of business cycle, let us have some basic information. And you have to join the Telegram channel for having the latest update regarding all of the lectures, so that you will be able to know which lecture is going to happen when, and you will be able to attend all of the live lectures of all of the educators. Okay, so it will be a very big help with the help of the Telegram channel, so that you will be able to come to know the timetable related to all the live lectures. So the link of the Telegram channel is given below in the description box. You can join it, that you will be able to have all of the latest update. Okay, so CA Foundation English Telegram channel, the link is given below in the description box. Apart from this, this is the timetable for all of the three educators. I want you to make a note for this, so that you will be able to attend all of the live lectures of all of the three educators, and you will not be missing any of the lectures with the help of this timetable. So make a note for this. Apart from this, everyone have to install Unacademy's learning app with the help of Play Store. Have installed Unacademy's learning app with the help of Play Store, so you will be able to have the benefit of Plus and Iconic courses. You will be able to subscribe for Plus and Iconic courses. As if you are going for the subscription of Plus courses, so you will be able to have the benefit of live class, weekly test, structured course, and unlimited access. If you will go for the Iconic subscription, then apart from the benefits that you are having with Plus, with that you are having some extra benefits in the Iconic subscription, as of personal guidance, study planner, study material, expert guidelines, and test analysis. Okay, so hurry up, guys. What are you waiting for? Install the Unacademy's learning app, so that you will be able to have the subscription of Plus and Iconic courses. As you all know, India Unacademy is India's biggest platform for education. As you can attend many of the simultaneous batch going on for the same course with the best educators, and that is what the great thing which Unacademy provide you, that you can choose your educator by yourself. Okay, so as you have installed the Unacademy's learning app and you have get the subscription for Plus and Iconic, then you will be able to attend classes of any of the educator. Okay, as if the platform is very, very big, so many more batches and many more simultaneous courses are streaming, so you can attend that. Okay, as we are having different subscription plan for Plus courses, different fee structure and different duration. As you can see, we are having 6 months plan, 3 months plan, 12 months plan, and 24 months plan. And for that, you are having the fees of 9,000, 10,000, 800, 14,400, and 19,800. That is what the fees of different subscription plan, and this is the Plus subscription, which is the for which I am talking with you, and you are able to have the discount also by using the code PRACHI10. Okay, so as if you will use the code PRACHI10, then you will be able to avail maximum discount. Okay, this is what the benefit which you get. So use the code PRACHI10 for having the discount. Okay, PRACHI PRACHI 1010. And as if you will go for Iconic subscription, so for Iconic subscription also we are having different plan structure. Okay, 6 months, 12 months, and 24 months. You can go for any of the subscription plan. We are having the fees of 22,500, 31,500, and 52,500. So you can choose your plan and you can subscribe it. And here also you can have the benefit of discount by using the code PRACHI. Okay, after After this basic information, let us start with the revision of business cycle. So all of you are ready with me? Okay. Okay, so we are going to do the revision of business cycle. Okay. Yeah. Just. Okay. Before starting with it, I want to tell you that in our economy, the situation which we are having, or not about our economy only, just we are talking about the economy of each and every country, we are talking about whole of the world. So we can say that the situation is never constant. As in our life also, the situations are never constant. It is like different phases are there which we face in our life. As we are having first the childhood, then we are having our teenage, then we are having our, you know, then we are having our youth age, then after that we are having our middle age, then old age. So that is what the things are changing according to the phases which we are having in our life. That is what also I am telling you in countries also. When we talk about economy also, so the things never go constant in an economy. Things never go constant. The situations are never constant in the economy. There are fluctuations in economy. As we can see, we are facing the situation of COVID. So because of this COVID situation, there are so much of fluctuation in our economy. Is it clear? So I am trying to tell you that the economy is never having the constant situation. There are always fluctuations in economy, and you have to deal with that fluctuation, and you have to accept that fluctuation. Whatever the fluctuations which you are having in your economy related to economic activity, that fluctuations is known as your business. Is it clear? That fluctuations is known as your business. So in short, I want to tell you that the economy is not having constant situation. Economy is always having fluctuating situation, and the situations are always going to change. And the business has to accept that situation and has to react according to the situation. Okay, so whenever there will be a changes in economic activity, that will have a great impact on your business, and the business has to accept all of that changes and have to respond accordingly. That is what all about the business cycle introduction. Let us see the meaning. Okay, meaning. Rhythmic fluctuations in aggregative economic activity that an economy experiences over a period of time are called business cycle or trade cycle. Yes, what they are trying to say? Whenever there are rhythmic fluctuation in aggregative economic activity, it is not about your area economic activity, my area economic activity, city economic activity, or state economic activity. They are talking about the aggregative economic activity. That means economic activity of a country as whole. So when there are rhythmic fluctuation in aggregative economic activity that an economy experiences, obviously there will be a change in economic activity, so that change will be experienced by that economy itself, right? So whatever the rhythmic fluctuations which you are having in the aggregative economic activity that an economy experiences over a period of time, that is known as your business cycle or trade cycle. Is it clear? In other words, business cycle refers to an alternate expansion and contraction of overall business activity as manifested in fluctuation in measures of aggregate economic activity such as gross national product, employment and income. They are telling us that there can be any change. Either you can have expansion, either you can have contraction in the economic activity, aggregative economic activity. And then there will be a change in aggregative economic activity as if with the help of expansion and contraction. So that will create a great impact on your GNP, employment and. Okay, is it clear? So you can also know the fluctuations with the help of GNP, employment and income, because with the help of these are the majors with the help of which you will be able to come to know what is a change in aggregative economic activity, as with the help of GNP, with the help of employment, with the help of income. These are the major indicators with the help of which you will be able to come to know which type of economic activity change is there in your economy. Is it clear? It has been observed that business cycles have been long lasting for several years, while others have been short ending in 2-3 years. Anything can happen. Any trend can be for long lasting years also, and some can be for short ending period also. You never know. You can never define the period of any of the business cycle phase. It is indefinite. It can be long also, it can be short. Whatever the phase which you are having in economy, you can never define the duration of that phase. It can be long lasting also, and it can be short ending also. You never know the period of any of the phase. Next, the trade cycle is composed of periods of good trades characterized by rising price and low employment levels. Okay, so actually what they are trying to say, that the trade cycle is divided into two. That is what, good trade and bad trade. So two things can be happening. Either you can have a good trade or either you can have a bad trade. So they are saying that when you are talking about good trade, so good trade is characterized with the help of rising price, low unemployment levels. And what they are trying to say, whenever you are having a rising price and low unemployment, that means it is an indicator of, it is a characteristic of what, good trade. And alternatively, when you will talk about bad trade, so in bad trade you will have the opposite reaction, that is what, falling price and high unemployment levels. Okay, so actually the trade cycle is divided into two, that is what, good trade and bad trade. So good trade, you can have good trade as when you are having rising price and low unemployment, that means it is an indicator, that means it is a characteristics of your good trade. And when you are having falling price and high employment levels, so that will be a characteristics of your bad trade. Is it clear? Now you will ask me, ma'am, hundreds of times you are telling us that there are different phases of business cycle. Business cycle is always fluctuating, the economic condition of the country is always fluctuating, we are having different types of phase, and the things never go constant. So you will ask me one question, ma'am, please let us know which type of fluctuations we are having in our economy. How many phases we are having in our economy? What are the possibilities of the phases which we can have due to the change in economic activity? You can ask me this question. Ma'am, please let us know which kind of change we can have in our economy with the change in economic condition, with the change in of economic activity. As if when we are having a change in economic activity or economic condition, so there we can have different phases. We are having four type of phases of business cycle. We are having four distinct phases of business cycle, that is what, expansion, peak, contraction and tough. Expansion is also known as boom or upswing. Peak is also known as prosperity. Contraction is also known as downswing and recession. And that is what, tough is also known as. So these are the four phases which are there in business cycle and which can be faced by each and every economy with the change in economic activity. With the change in economic activity, you can have any of this business cycle phase. So as you can see, we are also having a diagram related to it. The starting point, that is what, the lowest point, is all about your tough. Is all about what, the when you are having your lowest turning point, so the lowest turning point is known as your tough. And in tough, you are having a very bad situation. When we are talking about the tough phase, you are having a very bad situation, in which you are having, low employment, in which you are having low production, low demand, everything is like bad. So that is what your tough period which you are having, and that is what the lowest turning point which you are having is all about your tough. Okay? And after that tough period, when you start recovering, when you start having good things, and when you start rising up, so that is what you are entering into an expansion period. That is what you are entering into an expansion period after the recovery. So after the tough period, when you have entered into the recovery, after that recovery, you will be able to enter into the expansion part. And in the expansion part, everything will rise. The demand will rise, your investment will rise, your income will rise, your employment will rise, everything will rise. And as you are going to expand and expand and expand, and as expansion At one time you will reach the period of peak. Okay, actually after having a great period of expansion, there is a situation, there is a time period when you have to stop, and you will reach the highest point, and that highest turning point is known as your peak, and that will be the end of expansion period and will be a start of your contraction period. And everything will go down and down and down, opposite of the expansion. So when the things will go down and down and down, that means you are entering into the contraction. And as you have entered into the contraction period, and after having a severe long term contraction period, you will enter into the depression and severe recession. And as you have entered to trough, and then again you will start with recovery and expansion. So that is what they are trying to say, that things are going on and on. It is like a cycle, it will go on and on. You cannot define the period, but you can have a conclusion here that we can have different types of phases in our economy, and you never know which phase will go how much long. But you can have a conclusion here is, we can have tough period also, after tough we can have expansion also, after expansion we will reach to peak, after peak we will go to contraction, after contraction we can go to recession, depression, and then again we will go to recovery. That is what one cycle ends and another cycle starts. That is what all about the business cycle phases which we are having. And we are going to study all of these phases in detail, so don't worry about that. Okay, just I've explained you the diagram right now. Now you will explain me that now what is that line, the trend line, what do you mean by that trend line? So when you are having a steady growth in your economy, excluding the impact of the phases, that is what means trend line. What did I say? When you are having a steady growth in your economy, excluding the impact of your all of the phases of business cycle, the steady growth which you are having is known as your trend line. So the steady growth is indicated with the help of that trend line. This is known as a trend line. And this trend line indicates the steady growth of your economy, which is there, excluding the impact of your phases of the business. Is it clear? And we are having four distinct phases of business cycle, that is what expansion, peak, contraction, and one by one in detail we are going to study all of these. Okay, so the next thing which we have to study is what features of business. Okay, what are the features of business cycle? Occurs periodically. Yeah, it will occur periodically only. Okay, any of the phase do not have any indefinite period. Any of the phase which we are having of business cycle never has the indefinite period. After some period, that phase has to end up and the next phase is going to start. That is what the things are periodical. Okay, after some periods the thing will change. You never know the duration, but the things are periodical. After some period the things will change. They do not exhibit the same regularity. Obviously, whatever the things which were there in the last phase, in the last cycle, it is not necessary that in the upcoming cycle you will follow the same regularity and the same time period of the phases. No, it will never happen. As if in the last cycle, whatever the duration you are having of different phases, it is not necessary that in the upcoming trade cycle you will have the same duration of all of the phases. It may happen that in the last trade cycle the depression was too long, and in the upcoming cycle the depression can be too less and prosperity can be too long. You never know, anything can happen. Okay, so it do not exhibit the same regularity. The intensity and duration of these cycles vary. Yes, the intensity of every cycle vary from the other cycle. The intensity of the last cycle will be differ from this upcoming cycle. This can happen. Okay, so intensity and duration of every trade cycle. The length of each distinct phase is also not definite. Yes, you cannot define length of any of the phase. You know it is going to change, it is periodical, and another phase will come, but when, you never. You can never have a judgment that when the boom is going to end and when the contraction is going to start. You can never define the period of the phase. It clear? Good. generally originate in free market economies. Yes, it generally originate in free market economy, but it is not like that the other economies are not having the phases of business cycle. No, it basically generally originates in free market economy, but other economies also have the four different phases. Okay, then they are persuasive as well. Yes, they are persuasive as well. It means what? The business cycle is everywhere in the world. It is universal. It is not like that it is for your economy and my economy. It is having a universal concept. And disturbance in one or more sectors get easily transmitted to all the sectors. Yes. As if in your economy, due to the business cycle, as if there is a change in one sector, it will also affect the other sector also simultaneously. Is it clear? Is it clear, everyone? It will also affect other sectors also simultaneously. Yeah, there can be a proportionate effect. One sector can be affected more and another sector can be affected less. But they are trying to tell you that as if there is a change in business cycle phases, it is going to affect all of these sectors. That means it is pervasive, applicable everywhere. And it is transmitted from one sector to the another. As one thing is affected, the other things will also be affected. Is it clear, everyone? That too proportionately. One sector can be affected more and another sector can be affected less. But all will happen. Then, compared to agriculture sector, the industrial sector is more prone to the adverse effect of the trade cycle. That is what they are trying to say. As compared to agriculture sector, industrial sector is affected more from the changes in the business. As if there is a change in a phase of business cycle, the industrial sector is affected more as compared to the agriculture. That is what proportionate effect we are having. Okay. Repercussions of business cycle get simultaneously felt on nearly all economic variables. That is what output, employment, investment, consumption, interest, trade and price level. They are trying to say that whenever we are having different phases of business cycle and there is a change in economic activity, so it is going to affect output, employment, investment, consumption, interest, trade and price level. Is it clear? These are all the economic variables which are commonly going to be affected in every of the business phase, every of the business cycle phases. Whatever the phases we are having, these are the common variables which is going to be affected in that particular phase. That too, they can have a different change, but these are the common variable which is going to be affected in every phase of business. Is it clear? Business cycle are contagious and international. MCQ question. Business cycle are contagious and international. Now you will ask me, now what do you mean by contagious? Contagious means what? The things which are spreading. The things which are spreading from one thing to the another. It is all about contagious. They are trying to say that when one economy is facing any of the phase of business cycle, so it will also impact to the other countries also. As if USA is having the period of recession, it will create impact to the other countries also. That means the phases of business cycle is having a contagious effect that it is going to spread from one place to the another. Is it clear? They begin in one country and mostly spread to other countries also through trade relations, because we are having trade relations. For example, the Great Depression of 1913 USA and Great Britain affected almost all the countries, especially the capitalist countries of the world. Have serious consequences on the well-being of the society. Yes. Whenever we are having a large change of, you know, phases of business cycle, so there are serious consequences on the well-being of the society. As in the period of depression, there were a serious impact on the well-being of the people. Is it clear? And for business cycle phases, we are having two causes. That is what? Internal. This is also one of the features. And external. Internal causes are known as endogenous causes. And external causes are known as exogenous causes. Is it clear? So these are the causes of business. Okay. Now one by one, we are going to study all of the four phases of business. All of you ready with me? Let us study the phases of business cycle, and I will tell you in very much of brief and the important things related to the phases of business cycle. So the first phase which we are going to study is all about what expansion. And the very basic and the common thing which you should remember related to expansion is what, guys? Expansion means everything is good. Expansion means everything is increasing. Expansion means everything is going high and high and high. Is it clear? So expansion means what? There is an increase in economic activity. Very basic. Oh, sorry. Expansion means what? There is an increase in every economic activity. That means increasing in national output, employment, aggregate demand, capital, consumer expenditure, sales, profit, rising stock, rise and bank. Increase in each and everything. And this phase continues till full employment of resources. You will continue with this phase till then when you are having a full employment of resources. Is it clear? And you can only have, and here involuntary unemployment is totally zero. What do you mean by involuntary unemployment? Involuntary unemployment is all about when you are ready to work, when you are having a degree but you are not having a work. So it does not happen in expansion phase. Expansion phase is a phase where you are having a full employment situation. Only you can have exception, only you can have frictional unemployment and structural unemployment. Only you can have frictional unemployment and structural unemployment, and that too is a very rare case we can have. Okay, frictional unemployment is all about due to the strike, due to the change in job, due to the suspension, due to the strike, lockouts and all. And when we talk about structural, so it is all about the structural changes in the economy. So as you cannot have unemployment in the expansion period, but that too, there are two exceptions in the case which can have unemployment, that is for frictional and structural. Price and cost tend to rise faster. Next, investment also occurs at the faster pace. Demand for all types of goods and services also rises. And there is an increasing prosperity and people enjoy high standard of living due to high level of consumer spending. That means what? Everything will go positive. After having the expansion period, eventually you will reach to peak. As after expansion period, you have reached to peak. Okay. So now what is going to happen in the peak? Let us discuss. Okay. So term peak refers to the top or the highest point on the business cycle. This you have to remember, MCQ question. Ask what is the highest point of the business cycle? What do you mean? What do you refer as the highest point of the business cycle? So the highest point of the business cycle is known as peak. And you have reached to the peak. So the term peak refers to the top or the highest point of the business cycle. In the later stages of expansion, the inputs are difficult to find as they are short and their demand and therefore input prices increase. What is going to happen? I will tell you. As if you are going for expansion and expansion and expansion and so much of production and you know, you are using the inputs and you are using the raw materials and all. But after some period, having a continuous production, demand and investment and all of the things, after some period, there will be a phase where you will be in a short of what? Where will you be in a short of input? And when you will be in a short of input and raw material, so the prices of input and raw material is going to increase because they are in short. As if the price of the raw material is being increased, so the price of the output will also increase. They are saying that only output price will rise rapidly, leading to the increase in cost of living and greater strain on fixed income earners. Very true. What they are trying to say? As if the inputs will go high. The input price will rise high as because they are short. So when the inputs price is high, raw material price is high because they are short. Okay. So because of that, the cost of production will increase. So the output will be expensive. And when the output will be expensive, the price of the output will rise. That time, the cost of living will also rise and there will be a greater strain on fixed income earners. The consumer begins to review their consumption expenditure on housing and durable goods. Yes, now the consumers which were having high demand and they were spending highly in the expansion period, now they will think that they should spend or not, and they will have a review on the consumption expenditure on housing and durable goods. Actual, thus the demand stagnates. Yes, after the peak, the demand is going to be stagnant. Means what? Slow down. This marks the end of expansion period. Yes, and this will be the end of expansion. Is it clear? Expansion period will go up and up and up and up till peak. And after peak, the expansion period is going to be end. And as peak is the point where is expansion is going to end and contraction is going to start. Okay. So peak occurs when the economic growth has reached a point. It will stabilize for a short time and then move it to reverse direction. Yes. So peak is the highest turning point. It is a point where the expansion will going to reach at its maximum. And the expansion is going to end. For that, the contraction is going to start. Peak is an indicator. Peak is an indicator where the expansion is going to end and contraction is going to end. Is it clear? Is it expansion is not an indefinite, expansion is not having an indefinite period. As after the expansion period, the peak will be the position where the expansion is going to end and contraction is going to start. So now, as the expansion is ended, we have reached to the peak. Now, the contraction is being started. And it is totally reverse of your, what? It is totally reverse of your expansion. So whatever the things are happening in expansion period, all of the things reverse to that will going to happen in the contraction. So contraction arises since the economy cannot continue to grow endlessly or indefinitely. Yes. The contraction arises since the economy cannot continually grow endlessly or indefinitely. You cannot have the expansion period endlessly and indefinitely. So after some point, you are having a period of contraction. So once a peak is reached, increasing demand is hurtled and starts decreasing in the certain sectors. Yes, during contraction, there is a fall in the level of investment and employment. As at the time of expansion, all the things were increasing. At the time of contraction, all the things are decreasing. Is it clear? So producers do not instantaneously recognize the pulse of economy and continue anticipating higher level of demand and so maintain their existing level of investment and production. Initially, in the initial period of contraction, producers were not able to come to know that the demand is going to be decreased. So what they are doing, they are anticipating that there will be a demand. So they are continuing with the level of production and investment. Okay. So then there will be a mismatch. Sorry, then there will be a discrepancy or mismatch between demand and supply. Okay, so where the supply will exceed the demand, because as the contraction period starts, the demand goes down. But the producers are having their view. They are anticipating that the demand will go high. So they are continuously doing their production. What is going to happen? There will be a mismatch. There will be a discrepancy and supply will be very high and demand will be very less. And this is a very bad situation which we are having. And initially this happened only in few sectors at a slow pace, but rapidly spread to all sectors. Initially it will have a slow pace, but rapidly it will increase. And after that, when the producers will come to know, oh God, supply is exceeding demand and we have done over excessive production and over excessive investment. So now what they will do? Now they will hold back their future investment plans and cancellation of all of the raw materials, orders and equipment and all types of inputs. After they will be able to realize that, oh God, the supply is so high and demand is less. We are doing wrong. We are doing wrong by doing more and more production and investment. So they will stop further production and investment. Is it clear? And such corrective action by producer generates chain in reaction of the inputs market. And the producer of capital goods and raw material in turn respond by cancelling and curtailing their orders. And this will create a great impact over the inputs as they are cancelling all of the orders of inputs and raw material. So there will be a great impact on the chain of the market. And this is the turning point and begins the recession. And after entering into the contraction, when the severe situation is there, then the producers are cancelling the orders, they are not doing production, they are not doing investment. After this, you are going to enter into the period of recession. And what is going to happen? There will be a decrease in demand. there will be a decrease in demand gradually, there will be a decrease in income, there will be a decrease in interest, there will be a decrease in goods and demand of goods and services, there will be a decrease in investment, there will be a decrease in employment. Okay, producers will lower their price in order to dispose of their inventories, whatever they are having earlier, as they have done the over excessive production. So to dispose of their inventories, what they will do, they will lower the price. Now the consumer expects further decrease in price and postpone their purchase. This is going to happen. What they will think? As price is decreased now, it will decrease more in future. We will not purchase right now, we will purchase in future. So what they are doing, they are postponing their demand. And due to reduced consumer spending, aggregate demand falls, generally causing fall in price, and the discrepancy between demand and supply gets widened further, and this process gathers a speed recession and becomes severe. And when this is going to happen and happen and happen continuously, so you will enter into the severe recession. As if these things are happening, so investment will also decline, as because the producer will be not ready to invest more and more, and they will be not ready to take credit from the bank, they will be not ready to do the investment, they will be not ready to do the production, and all the things will go decline. And investment starts declining, production, employment decline, resulting in further decline in income, demand and consumption of both capital and consumer goods. MCQ question. So when there is a period of contraction and recession, there is a decrease in demand of both capital and consumer goods. Business firms will become pessimistic regarding to the future. They will have a pessimistic view. Oh no. They will be having a pessimistic view related to all of the demand in the future. So they will not invest. They will not do the production. They will not take the credit. And the bank will also bear the loss, and the interest rate will also go down. Okay. That is what they have written. Bank credit shrinks. Borrowings for investment declines, investor confidence is at lowest, and stock prices will also fall, and unemployment will also increase. All things is going to the bad situation. After having such a bad situation, we have entered into the period of depression. Okay, so demand for products and services decreases, and some firms will go for shutdown, some will lead to bankruptcy. And capital and consumer goods industry suffer from excess capacity, and there is no demand. Unemployment increases, there will be a fall in interest rate, and there will be a lower interest rate. That means the demand for credit declines, and there will be a pessimistic view of business firm. There will be no confidence in the future date. That is what all also leads to financial crisis. And there will be a debt depression, which we are going to see. And after facing such a bad period, we are going to enter into the recovery. Now, after having a very much depression and recession period, slowly we are going to start with recovery. As because in recovery period, the people will start to have any of the employment which they are getting at low wage rate also. So when the people will start doing or taking an employment at the low wage rate also, so slowly the wage rate is going to be increased. Slowly the consumption is going to be increased, slowly the demand is going to be increased, slowly the production is going to be increased, and slowly the producer is going to have the optimistic view regarding the market, and they will start taking the credit, they will start doing the investment and production, and so slowly the things will go to the recovery. Okay, and business confidence will build up, and slowly we will have a turning point. Okay, we will have a lowest turning point, and we will turn into the phase of recovery, and we will enter into the phase of expansion. Is it clear? This was all about here, all of the phases of business. Is it clear? So we have seen features, we have seen the phases. Let us discuss the indicators of business. Okay, let me have a sip of water so that we will proceed further. Let us discuss the phases of business, or indicators of business. And this is very easy. Indicators of business cycle is all about, we are having three indicators. And the indicators are very helpful because you are not able to judge the turning point. you are not to judge the turning point is very hard. You never know when you are having the turning point. So indicators are must to judge the turning point of any of the business cycle phases. So to judge the turning point of the phases of the business cycle, here we are having three indicators: leading, lagging, and coinciding. One by one, we are going to see. So leading indicators is an indicator. It is measurable economic factor that changes before the thing which I am highlighting. You have to remember that specifically. So it is a measurable economic factor that changes before the economy starts to follow a particular pattern of trend. That means here you can predict the future. Here you can predict the future before the economy starts to follow a particular pattern of trend. So before the economy has been started to follow a pattern or a trend, before that only you have predicted what is going to happen in the future. When you are having a prediction related to the future because of some of the aspect, that is what leading indicators. So leading indicators will help you to have the prediction of future. Is it clear? As if people are buying more and more capital goods, so that is your leading indicator. With the help of that indicator, you will be able to come to know that in the future people are going to do more and more production because they are buying right now the capital goods. This is what all about the leading indicator. So it represents the variable that change before the real output changes, that is prior to large economic adjustment. Is it clear? So before having the change in the trend, with the help of the indicator, when you predict the future, that is what all about your leading indicator. Next one is what opposite to leading, lagging indicator. So it reflects the economical historical performance. So when you are having a historical past performance, and on the basis of that past and historical performance, you are going to have your future prediction. That is what all about the lagging indicator. So it reflects the historical performance and changes in the indicators that are observable only after an economic trend or pattern has already been occurred. So when the things have already been occurred, already been happened in the history, you are observing the things after occurrence of all of the things, so that will be your lagging indicator. So when you are having the things after the trend, in leading we were having before the trend, so you were predicting the future. So in lagging, the things is been happened, it is a historical performance with the help of which you are absorbing the things. Is it clear? So when the things are happened already, when you are observing the historical performance and you are having the observation related to that after the trends which have been followed, that will be your lagging indicators. So it represents the variables that change after the real output changes. So after the real output changes and when you observe the things, that is what your lagging indicators. Measures that change after an economy and has entered a period of fluctuation. Leading indicators signals the onset of business cycle and lagging indicators confirm this trend. Yes, because the things are already happened, no, that means they are fact. So lagging indicators will give you the confirmation and leading indicators will give you only the future prediction and give you the signal. Some examples of lagging indicator, this can be asked as MCQ: unemployment, corporate profit, labor cost per unit, output, interest rate, consumer price index and commercial lending activity are the examples of lagging indicators. Coincident indicator. What do you mean by coincident indicator? Coincident indicator are the indicators which occur simultaneously with the business cycle. So the things which occur simultaneously with the business cycle is all known as your coincident indicator. It gives information about the rate of change of the expansion and contraction of an economy more or less at the same point of time. Same point of time when the phase of the business cycle is going either expansion or contraction. So at the same time when they will give you the change which is happening simultaneously, so that is what all about your concurrent or coincidental indicators. Coincide fairly closely with the change in the cycle of economic activity. They describe the current state of business. Example: GDP, industrial production, inflation, personal income, retail sales, financial market trends such as stock market prices, etc. are the examples of coincident indicators. Very good. Next concept. Causes of business cycle. There are two main causes of business cycle, that is what internal and external. Internal causes are also known as the endogenous causes, and external causes are also known as exogenous causes. You should remember this because this can also be asked as the MCQ. Is it clear? Okay. So one by one we are going to study all of these causes. Ready with me? Okay, so one by one we are going to study all the internal and external causes because of which we are having the business cycle phases. So for as we are having the business cycle phases differently, behind that we are having some of the causes, and because of these some of the causes we are facing the fluctuational phases of business cycle. So one by one we are going to study. So first one is what? Internal cause. Internal cause is also known as what? Your endogenous cause. That is what the within the organization causes which you are having, and because of which you are having the fluctuation in phases of business cycle. So first one is what? First one is price fluctuation. And points related to price fluctuation is explained by Nicholas Kaldor. He explains the Cobweb theory. You have to remember all of these things. Okay. You have to remember all of these things as because this can be asked as MCQ. So things related to price fluctuation is being explained by Nicholas Kaldor in Cobweb theory. And according to him, he wants to say that whatever the current prices which we are having right now is going to affect substantially to your future productions. What did I say? Whatever the current price which you are having right now, it's going to affect substantially your future production. What did I say? It is going to influence the production in the future, in the sub-future date. Once again, what does Nicholas Kaldor say in his Cobweb theory? So Nicholas Kaldor says in his Cobweb theory that currently whatever the price which you are having is going to have substantial effect in the on your production in the some future date. Is it clear? Once again, Nicholas Kaldor explains the theory related to price fluctuation, and he gives the theory as Cobweb theory, and he explains that whatever the price which you are having currently is going to substantially affect on your production in some future date. Then innovations. Yes, innovation is also a cause for change in business cycle. Okay, it is also an internal cause of business cycle. Innovation theory is given by Schumpeter. And he says that you have to accept innovation, and innovation is very important. And innovation theory is given by whom? Innovation theory is given by Schumpeter. And he says that whenever you are having innovation, there will be a change in the phase of business cycle, and you have to accept that innovation. Economy runs on innovation itself. Innovation theory is given by Schumpeter. Then, fluctuations in investment. Yes, fluctuation in investment is also a cause of business cycle. When you are having more investments, and what did I say? When you are having high investments or more investment, that means it will indicate the expansion period. That means you are in a expansion period. And when you are having less investment, that means you are entering into a contraction. That is what investment is also a reason for change in a business cycle, change in the phase of business. And there are change in investments also. It will indicate the different phase of business cycle. Whenever you are having change in your investment in the economy, that means it will also indicate the change in the phase of business. Is it clear? Then fluctuations in government spending. Yes. Either you can have high government spending. Okay, I will write it here properly. Either you can have low government spending. So when you are having high government spending, that means what? Expansion period. When you are having low government spending, that means what? Contraction period. That is what I am giving you in a very much a brief, so that you will be able to keep it in your mind and you will be able to solve MCQ related. High government spending, expansion; low government spending, contraction. Then, macroeconomic policies. Yes, macroeconomic policies are also the cause for business cycle. You can have two types of macroeconomic policies, as expansionary policies and anti-expansionary policies. When we talk about expansionary policies, means what? When the government spending is increasing, interest rate is increasing, okay, credit is increasing, all things are going in a positive way. So when you are having this type of things, that means what? It will lead to the expansion period. And whenever you will have opposite of all of that, that means you are entering into a contraction. When you are having a high spending, when you are having a high interest rate, when you are having high investment, when you are having low tax rate, so that will be your expansionary policies, which with the help of which you are going to have expansion period. And when the opposite things you are going to have, low interest rate, less investment, high tax rate, so this will be your anti-expansionary policies, and this will lead to contraction. Is it clear? Then, money supply theory is given by Hottrey. Who has given the money supply theory? Money supply theory is given by Hottrey. And Hottrey says that trade cycle is a monetary phenomenon. What did Hottrey say? Trade supply is a monetary phenomenon. It depends upon the money supply. Higher the money supply, that means you are in the expansion period. Lower the money supply, that means you are in a contraction period. Is it clear? And in very brief, I am telling you, and you can also make a note for this. Then, psychological factors. Psychological factors is given by Pip. Who has given the psychological factors? Pip. He says that your business cycle also depends upon the psychological factors of the businessman, psychological view of the businessman. And businessmen have two psychological views, pessimistic and optimistic. So whenever the businessman will have pessimistic view, so there will be a period of contraction, because they will not think for the investment, they will not think of the production, they will not think of the credit. Is it clear? And whenever the businessman will have optimistic view, that means you will be able to have the expansion period, because all the things will be going to happen as positive. Is it clear? When you will have a pessimistic view, that means you will have contraction period. Optimistic view, that means you will have an expansion. So this psychological factor theory is given by Pig. And one point is missing here, that is what? Your effective demand. Effective demand theory is given by Keynes. Who has given the effective demand theory? Effective demand theory is given by Keynes. And Keynes want to say that when there is an increase in effective demand, that means it is a period of expansion. And when there is a decrease in aggregative effective demand, that means there is a contraction. So when there is an increase in effective aggregative demand, that means there is expansion. And when there is a decrease in aggregative effective demand, that means there is a contraction. So many things we have seen in internal causes. That is what cobweb theory by Nicholas Kaldor, innovation theory by Schumpeter, fluctuation in investment, fluctuation in government spending, macroeconomic policy, money supply by Hottrey, psychological factors by Pig, and effective demand by Keynes. Is it clear? Very good. Now, these are very easy. External causes. Yes. First one is what? Population. When your population rate is exceeding your economic growth rate, so that is a very bad situation, because as if your population rate is increasing as compared to your economic growth rate, that means you will have less saving, then you will have less investment, then you will have less demand. So that will be leads to the period of contraction. Is it clear? And all the things will be reduced. And employment will also reduce, income will also reduce, investment will also reduce, production will also reduce, and all of this is going to happen. An inverse effect we are going to have when we are having high economic rate as compared to your population growth rate. Is it clear? Is it clear? Okay. Then, natural factors. Yeah, flood, drought, natural calamities, weather conditions are all also reasons for having fluctuations in your business. Then technological shocks. Yes, suddenly as if there is a change in technology and you have to adapt that. That means what? All about your technological shock. Wars. Yes, whenever you are in a war situation, so what you will do? You will think more and more about the equipments and the arms and ammunition, goods and services, but you will not have focus on your consumer goods and capital goods. That will lead to contraction, recession. Okay, and after when you have finished with the war, So the post-war reconstruction is all about, you will start with the phase of recovery and you will start with the production of capital and consumer. International trade, yes, whatever the things are going on internationally, that will also affect the risks and other factors. Okay. Next concept. That is what role of business cycle. Very easy, role of business cycle. That is, we are going to study how business cycle is relevant. How business cycle is relevant for making business decisions. What we are going to study, how business cycle is relevant for making the business decisions. We can say relevance of business cycle in making business decisions. What did I say? Relevance of business cycle study in making of business decisions. So as you all know, demand is also related to your business cycle. More effective aggregative demand, that means a period of expansion, and less effective aggregative demand, that means contraction. So with the help of the phase of business cycle, you will be able to come to know about the demand, and with the help of that you can take the production decisions itself. Is it clear? So with the help of the business cycle phases, you will be able to come to know about the demand. You will be able to take the decisions related to the production. Is it clear? Very good. Policies. Yes, you can frame the policies with the help of the business cycle phases, whatever the phases has been going on. As if the downsizing is going on, so what kind of policies is to be framed in the period of downsizing, depression? As if the expansion period is going on, so what type of decisions should be taken related to that then? Expansion aspect. What is next? Expansion aspect. Okay. So you have to also think about the expansion aspect. Whenever you want to do the expansion, okay, and whatever the phase of business cycle is going on, you are going to take decision according to that. As if you want to have new business, as if you want to launch new product, first you have to see the business cycle phases. As if there is a period of contraction, it is a very bad decision to have to launch a new business and to launch a new product. Very bad decision. As if you want to have an expansion aspect, then you have to think about the business cycle which is going on. Is it clear? Then, production aspect. Yes. What is production aspect? You have to think what are the prices of input is going on and how the cost of living is going to be increased. And according to that, you have to think, you have to stop the production, or you have to start the production, or you have to increase the production, or you have to decrease the production. That is also a very important phase, as sometimes the inputs are very expensive, sometimes the inputs are very cheap. So according to that, you have to think, you have to increase or decrease the production. Is it clear? Then, cyclical business. As you all know, we don't have uniform effect of business cycle on all over the sectors of the economy. Every sector is having a proportionate effect. Some sectors are having immediate effect. Some sectors are not having immediate effect. They will have effect, but after some time, or not that much. So the businesses which are affecting immediately due to the phases of business cycle, that business is known as a cyclical business, which are getting affected immediately due to the phases of business. Example of that cyclical business are construction, restaurants, infrastructure, advertising, and all of that. And the business which are not affected immediately, that are not known as cyclical business, for example, agriculture. Is it clear? And the last one is market entry and product. Yeah, you should think about this. You should think about that you have to do a market entry or product entry right now or not. What are the business cycle phases is going on, and according to that you will take a decision related to the market entry and product. Is it clear? So the last part of this chapter is what? Examples of business cycle. Okay. And in very much of short, I will tell you about this. We are having three examples: Great Depression, IT bubble burst, and global economic crisis. So everyone with me? So Great Depression period, actually it was the greatest and the longest depression period which has been faced by whole of the world, the universe. Basically it was started from US in the 20th century 1930, and the global GDP fell around by 15% in 1929 and 1932. Okay, and this was the period where the whole world was facing a period of depression, and many economists have given the different reason for this depression. As according to John Maynard Keynes, he said that there was a lower aggregate expenditure in the economy. That is why we are having the massive decline in income and employment. And because of this, we were having the period of Great Depression. This was the first view given by John Maynard Keynes. According to other monetarists, they opined that Great Depression was caused by banking crisis and less money supply. And other economists says that due to the deflation, over-indebtedness and lower profit and pessimism to be the main cause of Great Depression. Depression caused widespread distress in the world as production, employment and expenditure fell. And after 1933, the economies were started recovering with the help of great money supply, increased in international inflow of gold, increased government expenditure, and some of the things which have been increased, and we have started to the phase of recovery. So this was the first example of your phase of business cycle which have been faced by whole of the world as the Great Depression period. Next one is what? IT technology bubble burst 2000. What was there? There was an IT bubble, and we were having new companies known as dot-com companies or IT technology or the dot-com companies which we are having, and which have covered roughly the phase of 97 to 2000. And during this period, the internet based companies were exploring, and they have been started, and they have been increased day by day, and to be referred to as dot-com companies. So as we are observing that we are having more and more internet companies, so what the bank have done, they have lowered the interest rate in 1998 and 1999 to encourage the startup internet companies and to borrow funds and to have more and more internet companies, because according to them, what they were thinking, in future we are going to have a massive growth in this internet companies. Okay, and venture capitalists also started investing in this small startup internet companies. Due to over optimism, we are not talking about optimism, we are talking about over optimism. So due to over optimism in the market, investors were less cautious and all have invested in the internet companies. And there was a great rise in the stock price and in the dot-com companies at that time. But after that, the companies offered their services or end products for free with the expectation that they could build enough brand awareness to the and to charge profitability rates for their services later. What they have think earlier, give it free right now, and later on when we will create our brand awareness, no, then we will charge high prices and then we will earn the profit. As a result, these companies saw high growth and a type of bubble developed. Initially, we assume the growth over profits mentally led some companies to engage in lavish internal spending and such as elaborate business facilities, and this company could not sustain long actually. And when you are jumping, see, whatever the things which we have done, it was not long term. So to be long term, you have to think about the sustainability and survival. But whatever the things which they have seen, it was an overnight success for a short period. After that, the bubble which was created related to dot-com company was burst, and the decisions were wrong of all of the venture capitalists and banks and all of the things and all of the company setups. The thinking was wrong, and whatever the things which we have done, over optimism and overspending, that all gone through a very bad phase, and all the things collapse of the bubble took place during the 1991 and 2000. Companies could not sustain long. And due to factors like growth over profit, mentally lavish internal spending, elaborate business facility without revenue models, the companies ran out of capital and were acquired or liquidated. So the bubble which was created was burst. Stock market crashed and slowly economies began falling downturn in their economic activity. Okay. The last one is, last part of this chapter is global economic crisis. So what was all about global economic crisis? And it was a crisis which was having the origin in US financial market. What was happening here is, as in 2000, the economy went to the recession. So to come out of the recession, the central bank of US had started that they will increase the money supply, and they will increase the money supply with less formalities, and they will not see the collateral and all of the things, and they will not go with the very much of, you know, scrutiny and very much of verification related to the securities and collaterals, and they will provide very free money supply in the economy. And they have started this, the large liquidity or money supply with the banks with lower interest rate credit become cheaper, and household even with low credit rates become to buy houses in the increasing numbers. Higher the demand for houses leads to higher prices, and led both household banks to believe that price would continue to rise. Yes. Excess liquidity with banks and availability of new financial instruments led bank to lend without checking the credit worthiness of the borrowers. Yes. So as all was going so good, so what bank has done? They have started giving the loans without checking the credit worthiness. And after that, the loans were given even to the subprime households and also to those persons who had no income or assets. Oh, or blindly they were providing the loans. Blindly the money supply was taking place. And houses were built in excess during the boom period. And due to the oversupply in the market, house prices becomes to decline in the process. And as we know, whenever the things go over, the prices go decline. That's because they are not having value that much. When you are having shortage, then you are having the value, right? When you are having over the things, at that time the prices go low. And it was like a very bad period because the banks were into the very loss, and they have entered into the financial crisis because people were not able to give the installment, people were not able to give the interest, the principal amount, and the banks have faced a huge loss. This was all about the global economic. This was all about the revision of the. We have done in just one lecture all the concepts related to this. At the time of exam, just watch 1 hour, and you will be able to complete whole of the chapter of business cycle. No need to study 4 and 5 parts, and no need to give 4 and 5 hours for just single chapter. With the help of this one lecture, you will be able to revise whole of the concepts of the. So guys, thank you. It was a great lecture with you all. Bye everyone. Okay. Thank you. Bye bye everyone. Take care. All the best for your exams. Study hard. Study well. Be confident. Solve as much MCQ as you can. And be confident. Don't be confused at the time of exam. If you have not installed the Unacademy's app till now with the help of Play Store, go with it, guys. And the Iconic subscription is the best one which you can go. It is a pocket saver, okay, as it will reduce your cost, and you can also have the discount facility with the code Prachitech. Till now, if you have not followed my profile on Unacademy's website, go and follow my profile on Unacademy's website. The link is given below. Thank you guys. Thank you for being there. Thank you for being so patient. It was a great time with you all, and I'm very happy to teach you all. All the best for your exams, guys. Take care, and I'm waiting for your results, and I'm waiting for the positive results. Bye-bye, everyone. Take care.